Hi guys, welcome back to another video. This one is a quick video on to say that basically my Raspberry Pi 5 died, and all I did was I was trying to change the case and take it out of his case and put a new case onto it, and but I had to remove the old heatsink from here, and the heatsink was stuck on pretty fast because the new case wouldn't fit on. Anyway, what happened was I powered it on, and all I got was four long flashes and three fast flashes, which I'll show you in a minute here. Right, so here I have the Raspberry Pi 5 powered up now. As you can see, with the power plugged on, the LED flashes here. One, two, three, four, and then three quick flashes. And basically, I looked that up online, and that's telling me there's a problem with the RP1 chip. So, if you look closer at the RP1 chip, turn on the lights. As you can see here, you see, it's missing a capacitor. It took me a while to figure out, and that is the issue. And this is what happens with the Raspberry Pi 5 plugged in. Absolutely nothing, no signal. So, just a bit of a warning, be careful with the Raspberry Pi 5's capacitors here, because when you put your finger to take off the old heatsink or anything like that, you can quite easily tear it here. I think I held it here and it must have come off like that. These capacitors are really tiny. They are 0201s, and they're really hazard solder. So if you don't want a dead Pi 5, just be careful. Okay, let's see what I can do about it. Right, you join me here on the Raspberry Pi 5. This is my third attempt. I first tried to use a hot air, but that wasn't successful because there wasn't enough solder. But I did manage to get one capacitor soldered on, as you can see there. Yeah, by the way, I'm using the cheap £28 microscope here. Oh, don't those capacitors look like ants? Right, a little test to see how solid the soldering is, and it seems to be holding firm. Okay, time for a little cleanup before I continue on to the next capacitor. Thank you. it's time for some liquid flux. So this is what I put down now. Right, I'm taking the next capacitor out of its packaging. Something I found annoying was the tweezers. The capacitor would get stuck to them. If it wasn't the magnetism, it was the flux, and it was a bit of a hassle. This is edited, really. It took about 10 minutes to place it correctly. I intended to use hot air on it, but there wasn't enough solder on the pads, so I come in and put some solder on there before I use the hot air. I had to be careful not to touch the capacitors at the top or affect the other one which I've got there. It looks easy, but it's not. I'm using really low budget equipment here. Right, let's have a check if I've soldered it on correctly and it's stuck on, which it appears to have been. Now I can commence on to the next stage. Right, I'm going to use some flux gel so I can use some hot air on it.
I lay down some copper tape to protect the other capacitors here before I give it some hot air. Right, before I actually tried this for real, I practiced on an SMD practice board, and they had 0401 SMDs. They were a bit bigger and easier than this. Here I was applying the heat and hoping the heat would and the flux would pull the solder to the pads. Right, next task was to remove the tape and clean up the flux, which I did off camera. And it was time to test it out. Okay, I've got my Raspberry Pi 5 here now, and it's time to see if my repair worked or not, or did I just waste 2 hours? I've got no SD card in this thing at the moment. I don't know what will happen. Okay, here goes. I'm going to turn on the power now. And we're waiting. Oh yes. And it's worked. I'm well happy with that. But we're not out of the woods yet. I'll try it with a micro SD card to see, but it's looking okay. Right, I'll shut it down and put a micro SD card and see if we're back to normal or not. Right, micro SD card is in and it's time to power it up. Well, it looks okay. I'm happy with that. There you go. I thought it was impossible to fix the capacitors because they were so small, and they really are small, and this was a really difficult job. Well, everything appears to be okay. It seems to have booted up fine, and I'm happy with that. And that concludes this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and stay tuned for my next video. If there's any issues, I'll leave it in the description below. Please don't forget to subscribe. Cheers.